Hello, everyone. My name is Uday Narayanan, and I am a Senior Solutions Architect at AWS. I want to thank you all for joining today's session, where we'll recap the new features announced for Amazon Redshift during reInvent. So Amazon Redshift is a fully managed petabyte scale data warehouse used by tens of thousands of customers to easily, quickly, securely, and cost-effectively analyze all of their data at any scale. So as we hear from customers and innovate, we are focused on three key pillars. The first is best price performance at any scale. So we have introduced things like automatic materialized views that can improve throughput of queries and lower query latency without any manual intervention. We have also introduced things like concurrency scaling to handle high peak demand workloads. Second is the ability to analyze all of your data easily. As customers are moving towards a modern data strategy with Redshift as their data warehouse, S3 as their data lake, and using purpose-built data stores, being able to analyze the data irrespective of where it is stored is becoming more and more important. So you can use Redshift data sharing to share data across multiple clusters. You can use federated queries to query your operational data stores from Redshift. And you can use Redshift ML to build machine learning models using just SQL statements in Redshift. The third is having an easy, secure, and a reliable service. So this is centered around making data warehousing easy for everyone. As the number of personas are growing, not everyone has experience with data warehouses. Redshift's goal is to provide an easy getting started experience where customers can get to insights quickly so they can focus on their business outcomes rather than worrying about managing data warehouses and provisioning infrastructure. But at the same time, they cannot sacrifice on things like security and reliability. So we have features like role-based access control, granular row and column level security controls, and other such features around security and reliability to make it easy to manage your data warehouse. All right, so now let's get to the key announcements from reInvent this year. A common architecture pattern we see today is using Amazon Aurora as your operational data store and Redshift as your main analytics system. Typically, customers have multiple Aurora databases that they are operating, which in turn requires multiple data pipelines to ingest data into a Redshift cluster from those Aurora databases. So in order to make it easy, we announced Amazon Aurora zero ETL integration with Amazon Redshift. With this feature, you can use Amazon Redshift for near real-time analytics and machine learning on petabytes of transactional data stored in Amazon Aurora databases. Data is replicated into your data warehouse within seconds after transactional data is written into Amazon Aurora, eliminating the need to build and maintain complex data pipelines. You can replicate data from multiple Amazon Aurora databases into the same Redshift instance to run analytics across multiple applications. This feature is currently under preview. For customers that want to ingest data into Redshift from Amazon S3, we already have the copy command as a simple way to ingest data into Redshift. But customers have to run this copy command periodically by either manually running it or scheduling it to run at a fixed schedule to bring in new data from S3 to Redshift, or sometimes they even have to build custom solutions. So in order to address this requirement, we introduced support for autocopy from Amazon S3. So this capability helps you automate the process of data ingestion from your S3 bucket into your Redshift tables, and it eliminates the need to manually and continuously do copy procedures to bring your data in. So with a low-code approach using the copy command, you can benefit from automating the ingestion without really needing experience of building any data pipelines. You also don't need to manually track loaded files in order to ensure duplicates aren't loaded. And finally, you can easily convert your existing copy commands into automatic ingestion jobs. So we had introduced streaming ingestion in preview earlier this year. This is an easy way to ingest streaming data into Amazon Redshift for real-time analytics use cases. So during reInvent, we announced the general availability for this feature. With Amazon Redshift streaming ingestion, you can connect to multiple Kinesis data streams or Amazon managed streaming for Kafka streams and pull data directly to Amazon Redshift without staging in Amazon S3. So as the data is coming into your data streams, it is available for analysis in Amazon Redshift in near real time. Some use cases that this can be used for are clickstream analysis for user data, analyzing IoT data in real time, fraud detection, and so on. Another feature that was made generally available in the data ingestion space during reInvent is around our collaboration with Informatica. Along with databases and Amazon S3, customers have other data sources such as third-party data, sources like Salesforce, Marketo, and others from where they want to ingest data into Redshift. For such use cases, we announced Informatica Data Loader integration, which allows customers to run high-speed, high-volume data ingestions into Redshift. This integration allows you to launch and operate Informatica Data Loader within your Redshift console and easily copy data without having to install additional components or write codes. So currently, there are 30 pre-built connectors supported by Informatica. So you can use these connectors to connect to the data source of your choice and ingest that data into Redshift. Now, before we talk about this next feature, let's quickly talk about data sharing with Amazon Redshift. Amazon Redshift data sharing allows for a secure and easy way to share live data for reading across Redshift clusters. So basically, it allows an Amazon Redshift producer cluster to share objects with one or more Amazon Redshift consumer clusters for reading purposes without having to copy the data from producer to the consumer cluster. Today, we have thousands of customers who are using data sharing. So as more and more customers are leveraging data sharing, especially in large-scale environments with multiple producers and consumers, customers have been looking for an easier way to manage that data sharing environment. So for that, during reInvent, we announced the preview of data sharing access control with AWS Lake Formation. This feature enables a simplified governance of Amazon Redshift data sharing by enabling you to use AWS Lake Formation to centrally manage permissions on data being shared across your organization. You can manage permissions in a granular way at a table level, column level, or a row level access to tables being shared in Redshift data sharing or even with Redshift external tables. As Apache Spark workloads are becoming extremely popular, especially for data processing and also for machine learning types of use cases, we are hearing from customers about finding easier ways for integrating Apache Spark with Redshift. Hence, during reInvent, we introduced the general availability of Amazon Redshift integration for Apache Spark. This is a simple way to speed up Apache Spark applications accessing Redshift data from AWS services such as Amazon EMR and AWS Glue. So with this, there is no need anymore of manual setup or maintenance of unverified Spark Redshift open source connectors. It also improves performance. And based on our study, we have seen that Amazon Redshift integration for Apache Spark enables applications on Amazon EMR that access Redshift data to run up to 10 times faster compared to existing Redshift Spark connectors. And it does so by pushing down relational operations such as joins, aggregations, sort, and scalar functions from Spark to Redshift to improve your query performance. Now, coming to security features, we announced data mask, dynamic data masking with Amazon Redshift. It is a new feature for customers that want to protect sensitive data, but want to manage data masking policies through a SQL interface. You can apply masking on a specific column or a list of columns in a table. And you have the flexibility of choosing how to show the mask data. For example, you can completely hide all the information about the data. You can replace partial real values with wildcard characters, or you can define your own way to mask the data using SQL expressions or Lambda user-defined functions. You can also apply conditional masking based on other columns, which selectively protects the column data in a table based on values in one or more different columns. This feature is currently in preview as well. Now, next is around availability and reliability. So as customers are running mission-critical workloads, they want to make sure they have highly available architectures for their data warehouse. With cluster relocation, we already have the capability to relocate your cluster to from one AZ to another during an unlikely event of an AZ failure. But for customers that want to minimize downtime as well as have capacity guarantees, we introduced Amazon Redshift Multi-AZ. A Redshift multi-AZ deployment is accessed as a single data warehouse with a single endpoint, and it helps you maximize your data warehouse performance by distributing workload processing across multiple AZs automatically. This feature, again, is under preview. AWS Backup is an easy way to centrally manage your backups across different AWS services like EC2, S3, RDS, DynamoDB, and other services. During reInvent, we announced the general availability of AWS backup integration for Redshift. So you can create backup plans and automate backup scheduling and also retention for your Redshift resources. You can also use these backups to restore Redshift data to a point in time based on cluster or the table that you specify. Now, we have been heavily investing on out-of-the-box performance improvements for Redshift and have introduced various new Redshift functionalities behind the scenes to improve performance. Some of them are listed here on the slide. For example, we have introduced vectorized scans for Redshift tables. We have added write capacity for concurrency scaling. So, in addition to reads, you can have your cluster scale up with writes to handle peak hour demands. For example, you know, for ETL types of workloads, when certain hours in a day when there is like heavy writes happening, your clusters can scale to handle that writes and improve performance. So as you can see, there are a lot of things happening behind the scenes in order to make Redshift even more performant. Now, we have many customers, such as LexisNexis, Intuit, McDonald's, Moderna, Toyota, Zynga, and others who are migrating from their legacy databases to Amazon Redshift. As part of these migrations, customers are looking for support for additional SQL commands that they can use on Redshift. For such use cases, we have introduced new SQL commands like merge, connect by, grouping sets, rollups, cubes to help with such use cases, and we are constantly adding more. Finally, here is a quick recap of the different new announcements that we talked about today. Here I have links to the announcement page, documentation, and as well as some blogs that you can look into to get a further deep dive into the different topics that we touched on today. With that, I would like to thank you all for your time. I have my LinkedIn information here. If you would like to connect with me or if you have any questions that I can assist with, please hit me up on LinkedIn. With that said, again, thank you everybody for attending the session. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.